Good morning, students. So far we have discussed families of distributions where the range does not depend on theta, that is the support is independent of theta. But we do come across many examples or situations where the range of the random variable depends on the unknown parameter theta. And so as a result, that distribution cannot be a member of exponential family. So to find minimal sufficient statistic or to carry out other inferential procedures on that distribution, we have to work it out separately. So can we construct a family of distributions where these kind of distributions will be included? So the answer is given through Pittman family. So here is the definition of Pittman family. So suppose fx theta, where theta is real valued parameter, is a family of PDFs where fx theta can be written like this. It is the ratio of a function of x and a function of theta, where the range of the random variable x is from a theta to b theta. So where a theta and b theta both are functions of theta, such that for every value of theta, a theta is less than b theta. And the parameter space is an interval of this type, theta l to theta u, where theta l represents the lower limit and theta u represents the upper limit. So if this condition is satisfied, then this f is said to belong to Pittman family, or this family of distribution is called as a Pittman family of distributions. So let us take an example. Say uniform 0 theta, can it be a member of Pittman family? So yes, it can be, by taking a theta is equal to 0 and b theta is equal to theta. But you would say that a theta is equal to 0, so it is no more a function of theta. But you can say that a theta, in this Pittman family, either a theta or b theta can be a constant. In fact, it can be a constant belonging to the extended real line. Means it can be, a theta may be equal to minus infinity and b theta may be equal to infinity. So this a theta and b theta, when they are constants, then they can belong to the extended real line. So, but both should not be constants, because if both are constants, then there is no more dependency on theta, and then the Pittman membership won't be applicable. So either a theta or b theta can be a constant. Then there are several situations where you will find a theta and b theta monotone functions. For example, a theta is decreasing and b theta is increasing, such as uniform minus theta theta, or a theta increasing, b theta decreasing. Or you can also have none of this, means both are increasing functions of theta. For example, uniform theta theta plus 1. So in all these cases, all these distributions definitely belong to the Pittman family. So can we, just like we have result for exponential family, we readily get minimal sufficient statistic if the distribution has membership of exponential family. So can we have similar result for Pittman family? So the answer is yes, we can definitely have similar result for Pittman family, and here it is. We are going to prove this result. So suppose fx theta is a Pittman family, then and following conditions are there. So suppose following cases are discussed, then so when a theta, the first case, when a theta is a, means a theta is a constant, then x ordered n is minimal sufficient for theta. Then the second scenario, when b theta is a constant, then when b theta is b, then a constant x, b theta is b, a constant, then x ordered 1 is minimal sufficient for theta. And when a theta and b theta both are functions of theta, with a theta a decreasing function and b theta an increasing function, then tx, which is maximum of a inverse of x ordered 1 and b inverse of x ordered n, is minimal sufficient for theta. Sorry, then maximum of a inverse of x ordered 1 and b inverse of x ordered n is minimal sufficient for theta. And when a theta is increasing and b theta is decreasing, then minimum of the same statistics is minimal sufficient for theta. So can we prove this? The proof is not at all difficult. There are only two major steps in the proof. The first step is to write the likelihood function or the joint PDF of x size in such a way that when you consider likelihood equivalence, it will be a lot easier to identify the terms depending on theta. And then once you have got the likelihood equivalence, it is a lot easier to find the minimal sufficient statistic. So the step which is common to all these cases is to write the likelihood function. So let us first work on it. So suppose fx fulfills Pitman's family's condition, that is, this is a Pitman family, then fx theta is ux by v theta, where x lies between a theta and b theta. Now suppose x1, x2, xn is a random sample from fx theta, then what will happen? Then the joint PDF will be like this. Two indicator functions will be there. One is xi should be greater than theta, and the other will be xi less than b theta. These indicator functions are nothing but the conditions which we impose here. X should lie between a theta and b theta. So how can I write it? So there are two conditions hidden here. First is x greater than a theta, and the second is x less than b theta. So I have included it through these two indicator functions. Now this should be true for every xi, and so I am taking the product here. So now let us try to simplify this condition. So it is as if we are dealing with n and n indicator functions here. So it won't be easily possible if you use this expression of joint PDF. So can we minimize the number of indicator functions needed? So yes, we can, by looking at the inequality again. So this is what we need. Xi should be between a theta and b theta for every I going from 1 to n. So I can rewrite this as this: a theta less than x ordered 1, less than x ordered 2, so on, less than x ordered n, less than b theta. Okay, so now x ordered 2 greater than x ordered 1, that is obvious, that doesn't need any theta. Similarly, x ordered n minus 1 less than x ordered n, that is obvious. So you don't need to bother about the order statistics starting from 2 to n minus 1, but you need to be careful about x ordered 1 and x ordered n. Why? Because their limits are depending directly on theta. So all these n and n indicator functions can be simply replaced by the indicator function associated with x ordered 1 greater than a theta, and the other indicator function which is associated with the event x ordered n less than b theta. So these can be written like this: indicator function of x ordered 1 greater than a theta and x ordered n less than b theta. So this joint PDF can be written like this in the simplified manner. So v theta raised to n will be there, product of uxi will be there. Now let us consider the first case when a theta is constant. Suppose a theta is constant. So you have this condition: a less than x ordered 1. So see here, earlier you had dependency on theta here in the lower limit. Now that is gone because a theta is a constant. So you need to worry only about this range, isn't it? This condition, x ordered n less than b theta. So now consider the likelihood equivalence. So suppose you have two points from the support of L, then the likelihood ratio will be like this. Product of this v theta raised to n will get cancelled. You will have product of uxi into these indicator functions upon product of uyi into these indicator functions. So now you don't need to worry about u, because it does not involve theta. But again, you don't need to worry about x ordered 1 also, because it does not involve theta. So you need to worry only about these two: x ordered n less than b theta and y ordered n less than b theta. So when these two indicator functions are same, means for every theta, when this indicator function is 1, this indicator function should also be 1. You don't need to consider the cases where this is 0 and this is also 0, because that will be, then x, y won't be in the support, na? And so you don't need to worry about all such points. So you should consider only those points where this x, y is in SL. Means what? You already have this, na? For the sample, means this indicator function should be 1. So whenever for every theta, when x ordered n is less than b theta, then y ordered n also should be less than b theta. This is what we mean by the matching indicator functions. So this ratio will be free from theta if and only if x ordered n less than b theta is equal to this indicator function is equal to this for every theta in the parameter space. Notice that this should hold for every theta in the parameter space. Now, as theta changes over the parameter space, b theta is also going to change or vary over its range space. And so you should be careful. So let us call this as equation 1. Now my claim is that this holds if and only if x ordered n is equal to y ordered n. So let us try to prove this claim. So suppose, if possible, suppose that x ordered n is not equal to y ordered n. They are not same. Suppose. So you can say x ordered n less than y ordered n or x ordered n greater than y ordered n. So, and still we are assuming that this is true. So x ordered n is not equal to y ordered n, and we still have these indicator functions equal for every theta in the parameter space. So in that case, I can always find, because x ordered n is not equal to y ordered n, so I am assuming x ordered n to be less than y ordered n. Then I can always find theta naught, a point in parameter space, such that b theta naught lies in this interval x ordered n to y ordered n. Okay, because they are not the same, na? So I'm going to find out theta naught such that this happens. So what will happen then if this is the case? Then x ordered n will be less than b theta naught, isn't it? But y ordered n will be greater than b theta naught. And so the second indicator function won't be 1, but the first indicator function will be 1. And so here you get the contradiction. And so this cannot be true. What cannot be true? X ordered n not equal to y ordered n cannot be true. And so you must have x ordered n equal to y ordered n. So this is how we prove our claim. So, so the likelihood equivalence holds if and only if x ordered n is equal to y ordered n, and so tx is equal to x ordered n is minimal sufficient statistic for theta. So now the second case, where b theta is equal to b, in the same manner you can prove the second case. So instead of x ordered n, you will get x ordered 1. So try to work out the case b on your own. Now the case, this should be case C, not case D, case C. A theta is decreasing and B theta is increasing. So since A theta is a decreasing function, A inverse exists. And so this inequality, x ordered 1 greater than A theta, you can rewrite as A inverse of x ordered 1 less than theta. This will change, na? This being a decreasing function, this inequality will change. And this is how you will get. So A inverse of x ordered 1 should be less than theta. Similarly, b theta is increasing means b inverse exists, and so this inequality, x ordered n less than b theta, you can rewrite as b inverse of x ordered n less than theta. So earlier you had two conditions, x ordered 1 greater than a theta and x ordered n less than b theta. Now you have these two conditions, a inverse x ordered 1 less than theta and b inverse x ordered n less than theta. So both of them should be less than theta means maximum of them should be less than theta. Means theta should be greater than maximum of them, right? So suppose this we call as tx. So the condition reduces to theta greater than t. And so the likelihood can be rewritten as product of uxi upon b theta raised to n into indicator function of tx less than theta. Okay, so now consider the ratio of the likelihoods. So tx less than theta, indicator function of tx less than theta upon indicator function of ty less than theta. So the same argument will hold here. So this ratio will be free from theta if and only if tx is equal to ty. So the so by likelihood equivalence, what do you get is maximum of a inverse of x ordered 1 and b inverse of x ordered n is minimal sufficient for theta if a theta is decreasing and b theta is increasing. Now similarly try to prove the next case, where a theta is increasing and b theta is decreasing. I am sure you will be able to construct it on your own. So now let us try to work out some examples of Pittman family. So fx theta is theta by x square, where x is greater than theta, theta is positive. So here what is the support? The support is open interval theta to infinity. What is the parameter space? It is open interval 0 to infinity. So support is depending on theta, and fx theta, can you write it as a ux by b theta? So yes, ux you can take as 1 by x square, v theta you can take as 1 by theta. So it will be ux by v theta. So a theta you can take as theta and b theta you can take as infinity, which is a constant. So I told you b theta can be b, where b belongs to extended real line. So therefore this is the case where b theta is a constant and a theta is a function of theta. And so this you can rewrite, this joint PDF you can rewrite as, what will be the joint PDF? Theta raised to n upon product of xi square, where each xi is greater than theta. Now each xi greater than theta means minimum of the xi should be greater than theta. So x ordered 1 should be greater than theta. This will be the joint PDF. And so using the result which we have discussed earlier, x ordered 1 will be minimal sufficient for theta. Even if you consider Neyman factorization theorem, don't you feel that x ordered 1 will be sufficient statistic? And now if you follow the likelihood equivalence, x ordered 1 will come out to be minimal sufficient statistic. Now let us consider another example, uniform minus theta theta. So here fx theta is 1 by 2 theta, where x lies between minus theta to theta. So here ux is 1 and v theta is 2 theta. A theta is minus theta, b theta is theta. So a theta is decreasing, b theta is increasing. So if you apply the previous result, tx is maximum of a inverse of x ordered 1, b inverse of x ordered n is minimal sufficient for theta. Now what is a inverse? So what is a theta? A theta is theta. So to get theta, what you have to do is multiply it by minus, na? So that you will have minus of minus theta, which is theta. So therefore a inverse of theta will be simply again minus theta, and b theta is theta itself. So you don't, inverse function will be the same. So b inverse theta will be simply theta. And so maximum of a inverse of x ordered 1 will be minus of x ordered 1, and b inverse of x ordered n will be x ordered n itself. Another way to get this is write the inequalities, minus theta less than xi less than theta for every I. So you can rewrite it like this. So you can again simplify it as x ordered 1 greater than minus theta and x ordered n less than theta. So x ordered 1 greater than minus theta you can rewrite as theta greater than minus of x ordered 1, isn't it? Apply minus, multiply by minus 1, so the inequality will get reversed. So you will have minus x ordered 1 less than theta, means theta greater than minus x ordered 1 and theta greater than x ordered n. So theta must be greater than maximum of them. So the indicator function based on all these will be simply replaced by this indicator function. So this is how you get the minimal sufficient statistic here. So let us stop here. So here the discussion about different families of distributions is over. One more family of distributions will be discussed in this course, that is Kramer family of distributions. So when we start the asymptotic part or the large sample part of inference, when we start studying large sample inference, then we will study the Kramer family of distributions.